I can give you a clue. It's one of the Achachans. You said, please welcome Jeff. Soon we'll push him out.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Firstly, I would like to thank God for giving me this opportunity, you know, to speak the word of God to you. It has always been my wish to speak the word of God to you. At the end, during some the past few weeks, I was not sure whether I would be able to do this, but the Lord saw my wish and granted me my wish to, you know, speak the word of God. I also thank Anish Angle for giving this opportunity for a Sunday school student to speak the word of God to other Sunday school students. When I was thinking about what to speak to you guys, you know, many topics came to my mind. And the one topic, when I examined my life, the word that came to my mind is faith. Specifically, faith in God. How many of you think about your faith? Do you know what is faith? What is faith? Yeah, it is trust in God. You see, the dictionary defines faith as a strong belief in a doctrine of religion based on spiritual conviction rather than proof. But the Bible teaches us that there are two ways we can have faith. Belief that, meaning, so God, suppose like believing in whether God is real or the Bible is true or not. And then the other way faith happens is by believing and trusting in His ways and understanding His nature during uncertainty. So, like, how do we have belief in God? There is two ways, through knowledge and through experience. So, you know, when I think about my life, when I was in eighth, actually, I started, you know, questioning my belief in God. And then I started exploring about my belief in God. And then finally I came to the conclusion that yes, I do believe in God. But then one day I saw that one of the preachers that I used to follow, after his death, you know, many controversial cases arised. And then I lost all of my hope. Like, how could someone with such knowledge about God still do such controversial acts? And then I lost my hope. And then at that moment, I got to know that it is not in people that we believe in. It is in God. It is our faith is not in human beings, but rather than in God. So if we want to really believe in God, we must experience the love of God or the connection we have with God. So for that to happen, there are many ways to have faith. But first, we must know why we need faith. So first of all, faith is the only way you can approach to God. Faith is the only way you can please God. Can someone read Hebrews 11 verse 6 for me, please? Hebrews 11 verse 6. Yeah. So, So can you read it again? Please. Sorry. 11:6. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, so the verse says it is impossible to approach God and please God without having faith. And you can only know God through faith. You know, only if you have faith, you can come and believe in God and understand His ways and how He works through your life. And you can only be, you are only saved by faith, according to Ephesians 3 verse 8 to 9. Can someone read that too? Ephesians 3 verse 8 to 9. No, 3 verse 8 to 9. Then 9. Yeah. So you are only saved by faith and nothing else. And the other thing you need faith for is that your prayers can only be answered if you have faith. As James 1 verse 5 to 8 and Mark 11 verse 24 says. Now, let me give you an example. So, Jesus, whenever you ask something in prayer, Jesus gives the answer to that prayer like in a package. But He gives it at that time itself. But He doesn't tell you when you will receive that package. And you can only receive that package in Faith Street. So only if you are in Faith Street, you can receive that package. If you are in, I don't know if whether it will happen in Boulevard Street, you will never receive it. You must be in Faith Street. That's why you need faith. Then after, we understand why we need faith, then comes the question, how to have this faith? See, we must understand that faith is not something that you get from outside or something that you receive. It is something that must come from within. For that, you must go to the cross. You must see the sacrifice that God has done in your life. Only then can you have faith. And then you have to be thankful for all the things God has done in your life. Only then I truly appreciate the ways that God works in your life. And also, we must have a relationship with God. When we have a relationship with God, our faith increases and we become much more stronger with God. Now, how do we have a relationship with God? By hearing the word of God and obeying the word of God. In Romans 10 verse 17, it says, as Romans 10 verse 17 says, so then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So, when we hear the word of God, when we meditate on the word of God, when we obey the word of God, only then can we have faith and have a much more better relationship with God. And then we can also have faith through prayer. We must always pray to God about our faith and our relationship with God. Prayer is a two-way communication to God, and it's the only way you can to communicate with God. And then we must also believe and accept God as our Savior and Jesus Christ. And we must profess this truth to everyone who we meet. You know, sometimes we might feel that, talking about religion is a bit embarrassing or something that we are afraid of or fearful of because we fear judgment. We might feel it's awkward, but know that it's not our relationship with others that matter. It's our relationship with God that actually matters. So, we must never be embarrassed or we must never fear any judgment. Like for example, right now when I am speaking to you about the Word of God, I might get some judgments about what I am preaching and whether I am doing what I'm preaching. And I do not take it as a negative. It's actually a positive. You know, it allows you to be it allows you to be in line with what God wants you to be. But we must also remember that everyone has shortcomings. So we must not be embarrassed if we make a mistake or if we do a sin. What matters is that we ask God for forgiveness and then we continue God in that relationship. Now, I also want to show you a video, if it's possible. And in that video, the video will explain more better what faith is and how faith must be like.
Made it safe.
Hey, Ava, watch this.
Oh. I totally meant to do that.
Cool.
Yeah, super cool, huh?
Oh, I just remembered. So in 3 days or maybe 4 days, but I think 3, I'm gonna be baptized. Wanna come?
Baptized? What's that?
Well, I'm gonna wear my pretty dress to the church.
I'll go inside where my family will be, and then I'll get in the water. And my dad, too. Then I'll go under the water. And then there's the Holy Ghost. Doesn't that sound great?
Ghost? Why are you gonna do that?
Because now I'm 8 years old.
I guess I'm just confused.
Oh, I thought I explained it good. Sorry. I'm gonna go now because I am.
Bye, Sophia.
You're home early.
Issy, did you have friends come see you get baptized?
Sure. Why?
I invited Ava, but when she asked why, I don't think I did a good job explaining it right.
You blanked out right when it mattered, huh? I do that too. Let's talk about it. So, baptism. It's a way that you show Heavenly Father that you're willing to follow Jesus.
I know. I can't wait.
And when we do that, we make a promise. And that promise is called a covenant.
Yeah, I make promises all the time. I made one at school today.
I need you to bring this back after recess, okay?
I promise.
But a covenant's a little different. It's a two-way promise, where two people each promise something to each other.
Like last night. Mom?
Yes?
Can I have dessert?
If you finish up your soup.
Promise?
Yes, I promise. If you promise to eat all your soup and put your dishes in the sink.
Okay. It's for the chocolate cake.
Right, but it's a lot more. Heavenly Father sets the conditions of the agreement, which are like the rules. If we promise to serve Him and keep His commandments, then He promises to bless us with His Spirit.
I agree to do whatever Heavenly Father says, and if I do that, He'll bless me with the Holy Ghost.
Exactly. Wow, you explained that better than I did.
Father, He promises to bless me.
You're doing it for blessings?
Yeah, He promises to be with me. And it's the right thing to do because Jesus did it. I want to be like Him. So wanna come?
Okay, I'll ask my mom.
And after, we may even get a treat back at my house.
But I'm not supposed to know that.
Ooh.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it was cool.
Super cool, huh? I felt so warm and happy inside. I know it was the Holy Ghost telling me that I made a good choice. Thanks for coming.
I like your dress.
Me too, and I like yours.
Thanks.
Watch this.
Whoop.
Whoops.
Whoop.
Whoop.
Hi.
Ashley, this is my friend Ava. Ava, this is Ashley. She's super cool, too.
So when I saw that video for the first time, I actually cried. Because did you notice that girl's faith? Did you see how she did not doubt anything else? She just wanted to be with Christ. She just wanted to be with God. That is her faith. That is, you know, whenever I look back at my faith, I wish it was like that girl's faith. Because I always doubted, you know, many things in my life. But she just wanted to be with Christ. And that is what faith is all about. That's what the relationship with God is all about. That's why in Bible says that our faith should be like a small child. Because you never doubt it. Even though you have doubts, you still know the ways of God and you trust in God. So always have a relationship with God, and it's like a commitment to God. You know, your faith should be that strong. And, you know, sometimes we might, you know, in some situations, we might feel that the Lord's presence is not there with us. You know, sometimes it feels like you can touch God and sometimes it feels like He's not there at all. But in those moments, those are the times that Lord is actually close to us. So, whatever hardships come in your way, we must always keep our faith. Now, let's all rise up on our feet and we are about to worship the Lord. We will sing a song and we will worship the Lord.